A very safe and good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th March, on the front page you have RBI cuts rates, allow loan moratorium. So to ease impact of lockdown, repo and reverse repo rates have been reduced. EMIs have been deferred for 3 months. So here you can see all lending institutions shall frame policies for providing relief to eligible borrowers. And repo rate has been cut by 0.75 percentage points to 4.4% now. And for all term loans, a temporary halt of 3 months is there. And here you can see the tenure for such loans will be extended by 3 months after the moratorium period. That means the installments are deferred, not waived. Means you'll have to pay later. Interest shall continue to accrue on the outstanding portion of the term loans during the moratorium too. And that will also have to be repaid. Then here you have center flags gap in screening travelers. So states have been told to track 15 lakh passengers, but cabinet secretary has said who has asked the states to effectively monitor 15 lakh international air passengers who came from January 18 to March 23. And there appears to be a gap between the actual monitoring that may seriously jeopardize the efforts to contain the spread of COVID-19. So now central government is blaming the states for not tracking the passengers who came. After that, international flights have been stopped. So from Jan 18 to March 23 is the date given here. Then below you have regarding how ventilators are being added. Government plans to add ventilators to battle virus. But important news here is this: India to join World Health Organization drug trial. So it is all set to join World Health Organization solidarity trial aimed at rapid global search for drugs to treat COVID-19 infection. So it will test 4 different drugs or combinations and compare their effectiveness. This is after ossification test, court grants minor bail. So here important is the bone ossification test which is conducted. So it is conducted to determine whether a person is a minor or not. So this is important, you should know about it. Then on page 2 here you can see how migrant workers continue march home and it is an imminent danger to their livelihood, which overshadows COVID-19 scare too. So authorities are arranging buses and food for them. So you can see food is being served to migrant workers stuck at Delhi Uttar Pradesh border near Ghazipur. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is RBI's guns boom. So this is regarding the front page news that India's financial system, the editorial says, will need more support as the virus crisis evolves. So RBI has finally rolled out some measures to contain the consequences of the COVID-19 on the economy. So we have seen on the front page how EMIs have been deferred and also repo and reverse repo rates have been cut. So this will bring in liquidity in the market as such. And below you have trial and turmoil. So this is regarding Israel, Israeli President Benjamin Netanyahu. He has earned another reprieve, but it might not last long. So this is regarding politics in Israel. It's Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. So he had a case against him and he contested the elections and won the prime ministership too. So the lead article is shift to upscaling food rationing now. So expanded rations will not only bring relief to this in this pandemic but also help sustain a nourished and healthy population. So this is an article which is speaking about food rationing so that food reaches all. So here you can see during the period of war, steps are taken like in UK 1940s rationing or a policy of fair shares was introduced in period of war and scarcity. Those are steps can be taken by India too. In China also, the planning body had ensured supplies of basic foods and price stability to the poor, especially in Wuhan province. So such steps need to be taken in India as such too, especially as the vast number of workers and migrants in towns and cities. They have to be delivered cooked food. So that is very important. And here you have, it's also a fight against punitive measures. So this article says that the requirement of massive resources following the pandemic may be an occasion to lift global economic sanctions. So global pandemic demands game-changing actions by all nations in order to halt its global spread. So here the article says that there are global sanctions which are imposed on various nations. So these can be removed now. The unilateral sanctions, which are naturally not mandatory to any other state, but the United States is often stipulated, like in the case of Iran, that those countries which do not apply sanctions to Iran would be debarred from doing business with the US. So such sanctions now need to be lifted. There should be a global change of global political change even after the pandemic. So that article talks of that. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have this Ground Zero coverage. So this is regarding the hoardings which have been put up in Lucknow by Uttar Pradesh police, identifying those accused of violence during Anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protests in December 2019. So they have been named, shamed and living in fear. The case had gone to the courts. Allahabad High Court ordered the UP government to bring down the hoardings within 3 weeks, it had given a time frame, but then the UP government approached Supreme Court, and Supreme Court said it would look into the matter. When the case went back to the Allahabad High Court, Allahabad High Court again ruled that it has to be brought down. And actually the Supreme Court had stated there is no law which gives the authorities power to do this. So there was an ordinance which was also promulgated by UP government in this context, that it can ask for compensation fine from those who involved in violent protests, and also they can be named as such to make people aware. Then on international page, you have British Prime Minister tests positive for coronavirus. So British Prime Minister Boris Johnson and his health secretary both have tested positive for COVID-19. The number of infections, he is British Prime Minister, and also the number of infections in US have surged to the most in the world. Spain announced a record number of virus deaths overnight. Then on business page, you have RBI unleashes its firepower. So this is regarding how EMIs have been deferred for 3 months and liquidity floodgates have been opened by RBI. So three steps which have been taken by RBI in this regard to infuse liquidity in the banking system are mentioned here. One, RBI has reduced CRR, cash reserve ratio requirement, by 100 basis points. Then you can see CRR, it has been reduced from 4% to 3%. Cash reserve ratio, that is the proportion of liquidity, proportion of liabilities which a bank has to set aside as cash. So that is reduced now, and so this will free up more money as such for the banks to lend out. So this will bring in 1.37 lakh crores, free up 1.37 lakh crores. And second step which has been taken is the cap for liquidity available under marginal standing facility has been increased. So that will also help in bringing up more liquidity in the economy, you can see. And third step which has been taken is the auction of long-term repo, which would take place by RBI, of 1 lakh crores. So in all, these three measures will infuse 3.47 lakh crores in the banking system. So we have seen earlier also targeted long-term repo operations would take place as such. So that is CRR, SLR as such is the another ratio, statutory liquidity ratio. So to increase liquidity available to banks under marginal standing facility, from 2% of SLR, it has been increased to 3% of SLR with immediate effect by RBI. And this will be applicable up to 30th June 2020. So you should know all this. So this is the reaction to RBI steps taken. Even Supreme Court has relaxed BS4 deadline. Bharat stage 4 deadline. So Bharat stage 6 had to be introduced in the country, but now because of the lockdown and the COVID-19 crisis, this deadline has been extended. So it was 31 March 2020 deadline for BS4 vehicles to be ended. BS4 vehicles can no longer be used. But now, looking at the extraordinary situation, the Supreme Court has allowed such vehicles to be sold further too. So this is there. Even Moody's has cut India's GDP growth forecast to 2.5%. And IMF, International Monetary Fund, says world is now in recession. Virus hit developing countries need dollops of funds. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.